7 of 1963. It was ascended on 13th day of December 1963 and came into force on 1st day of March 1964. It is mentioned on entry number 7 in concurrent list of Constitution of India, and it is supplemental to Indian Contract Act, and it is preventive and protective in nature. The Act is divided into total of 3 parts, 8 chapters, and there are total 44 sections, out of which section number 43 and 44 has been repealed. प्रिलिमिनरी पोर्शन जो है वो एक्सक्लूडेड है. चैप्टराइजेशन जो है वो पार्ट नंबर 2 से शुरू होता है. पार्ट नंबर 1 इज प्रिलिमिनरी, पार्ट नंबर 2 इज स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ. टोटल आपके पास 6 प्रकार के स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ है. फर्स्ट वन इज रिकवरिंग पोजेशन ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, सेकंड वन इज स्पेसिफिक परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, थर्ड वन इज रेक्टिफिकेशन, फोर्थ वन इज रेसेशन ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, फिफ्थ वन इज कैंसिलेशन एंड लास्ट वन इज डेक्लेरेशन. इसके अलावा आपके पास प्रिवेंटिव रिलीफ है जिसमें आपको कोर्ट जो है इंजंक्शन ग्रांट कर सकती है. इंजंक्शन में भी टेम्प्ररी और परपेचुअल. सेक्शन नंबर 1 इज शॉर्ट टाइटल एक्सटेंडिंग कमिसमेंट, सो दिस एक्ट में बी कॉल्ड स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ एक्ट 1963. इट एक्सटेंड टू द होल ऑफ इंडिया एंड इट केम इनटू फोर्स ऑन 1st डे ऑफ मार्च 1964. सेक्शन नंबर 2 में डेफिनेशन है. टोटल 5 डेफिनेशन है. सबसे पहले है ऑब्लिगेशन. एवरी ड्यूटी इनफोर्सिबल बाय लॉ इज ऑब्लिगेशन. देन 2B इज सेटलमेंट. सेटलमेंट मीन्स एनी इंस्ट्रूमेंट अदर देन विल और कॉडिसिल एज डिफाइंड इन द इंडियन सक्सेशन एक्ट. Under which devolution destination of any movable property or immovable property is disposed of or agreed to be disposed of. Then trust has the same meaning as defined under section number 3 of Indian Trust Act. Trustee has the same meaning as defined under Indian Trust Act.
Then
any other worded expression which is not defined under this act means a specific relief act and defined under Indian Contract Act shall have the same meaning respectively. सेक्शन नंबर 3 बात करता है सेविंग की. सो नथिंग इन दिस एक्ट शैल बी डीम्ड टू डिप्राइव एनी पर्सन एनी राइट टू रिलीफ व्हिच ही मे हैव अंडर इंडियन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट
एक्ट. ओके, व्हाट इज सेक्शन 5?
सेक्शन नंबर 5 इज रिकवरिंग स्पेसिफिक इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी. अ पर्सन एंटाइटल्ड टू रिकवर पोजेशन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी मे रिकवर इट इन द मैनर प्रोवाइडेड बाय कोड ऑफ सिविल प्रोसीजर.
Section 6.
Section number 6 says, if a person is dispossessed without his consent from immovable property otherwise than in due course of law, he may by suit recover the possession. But such suit shall not be instituted after the expiration of 6 months from the date of dispossession and well against the government.
Very good. Again.
No appeal shall lie to any decree passed to any decree or order passed under
review.
No appeal or review shall be allowed. And subsection 4, any person may establish his title by
any. Okay, nothing in this section shall prevent any person to establish any title other than this. Mm-hmm. Very good. Achha, chalo batao section number 15. Aisa rahega.
Who may obtain a specific performance? So following person may obtain a specific performance. First, parties to the suit. Second, representative in interest and principal. Provided that representative and principal shall not obtain a specific performance if it is based on a personal qualification of the parties. And unless it is unless representative in interest or principal has performed their part of a contract and it is accepted by the other parties or their representative in interest or principal. Third, when it is a contract on a settlement of marriage or compromise of doubtful rights between the parties, any person who is beneficially entitled there under.
Okay. Fourth, achha, how will you define section 41? How will you define temporary injunction?
Temporary injunction are such as are to continue until a specified period of time or
perpetual
until
further injunction.
Perpetual injunction are only granted at the decree upon merits of the case and upon hearing of the parties. Thereby, defendant is perpetually enjoined from the assertion of any right or commission.
When
of
injunction cannot be granted.
Injunction cannot be granted, section number 41. To restrain any person from prosecuting a judicial proceeding in a court where injunction is pending. Second, to restrain any person from prosecuting any judicial proceeding to a court not subordinate to that from where injunction is sought. Third, to restrain any person from prosecuting, from instituting to any legislative body. And to restrain any person from prosecuting a judicial proceeding related to criminal matter. To prevent the breach of a contract, which contract cannot be specifically enforced. To prevent the nuisance, which is not reasonably clear that this act will be a nuisance. And where equally efficacious relief can certainly be obtained, no injunction can be granted. Injunction cannot be granted to where it would impede or delay the progress of any infrastructure
project. Progress or
project.
Completion of any infrastructure project. Okay, how will you define FIR?
Every information relating to the commission of any cognizable offence, if given orally to an officer in charge of a police station, shall be reduced to in writing by him or under his direction, shall be read over to the informant.
Okay, complaint.
2D, complaint means any allegation made orally or in writing to a magistrate with a view to his taking action under this code that some person, whether known or unknown, has committed an offence but does not include a police report. Explanation, a report made by a police officer after the investigation which discloses the commission of a non-cognizable offence shall be deemed to be complained.
Okay, wonderful. Go.